You're watching part 2 of Creating a REST API with Mendix. I'm Jeff Goldberg. In this section, I'll go through creating a domain model and adding the bones of the REST API. A domain model in Mendix is the database for the app. The database contains tables called entities. And I'll create the first entity now by clicking on the entity button here at the top and placing it on the canvas. Double-clicking on the blank entity opens up the properties where I can change the name. Let's name this table Vehicle. Next, I'll add some attributes. Attributes are the same as fields in a database table, and when you create them, you can set their type and certain behaviors about them. I'll add a primary key field called Vehicle ID with an auto number type. Then add a make field as a string. I'll speed up through creating the rest of the fields. You can slow the video down to see all the fields created if you want to follow along with the example. The last field I'm going to create is style, and I want this to be a set list of values the user can choose from. In Mendix, this is called an enumeration, and it represents a collection of static values. I'll create a new enumeration called vehicle type and start adding values. I'm going to add values ranging from sedan to SUVs to trucks. Then I'll set a default value, and we're good. Now that the database is built, let's get started on what we're really here for, and that's the REST API. To organize my API, I created a folder in the Project Explorer. Right-click on that folder and select Add Other, and then Published REST Service. I'll name the new service Collection and click OK. I'm brought into the REST service interface, and I'm presented with a number of properties. I want to change my location URI slightly, so I'll click on Edit and do that, basically flipping the V1 to the front and removing the word REST. Just tidy it up a little bit. Then I'll add some documentation for the top level of my API. One of the cool parts of REST APIs with Mendix is the platform generates documentation using the Swagger Open API specification. In addition, I can add content to the documentation in GitHub Markdown, which is great because I like Markdown and I like GitHub. The last bit for this video is to create a resource for our API. A resource is synonymous with a REST endpoint. Let's create the vehicle endpoint and provide some doc. Okay, we created our database and started the build out of our collection API. In the next section, I'll build the first method to get a list of all the vehicles in my collection. See you soon!